up out of bed instead of getting on the internet and checking a new hit. Me get up, first shot, come strut walking. A little bit of humble, a little bit of cautious. Somewhere between like Rocky and Cosby's for the game. Nope, nope, y'all can't copy yet. Bad moonwalking, and this here is our party. My posse's been on Broadway, and we did it all way. Chrome music, I shed my skin and put my bones into everything I record to it. And yet I'm on, let that stage light go and shine on down. Got that Bob Barker suit game and Plinko in my style. Money, stay on my craft and stick around for those pounds. But I do that to pass the torch and put on for my town. Trust me, on my I-N-D-E-P-E-N-D-E-N-T. It's hustling, chasing dreams since I was 14 with the Fortrait busting. Halfway across that city with the back, can't crush it. Labels out here, now they can't tell me nothing. We give that to the people, spread it across the country. Labels out here, now they can't tell me nothing. We give it to the people, spread it across the country.
Here we go back, this is the moment. Tonight is the night, we'll fight till it's over. So we put our hands up like the ceiling can't hold us. Like the ceiling can't hold us.
Here we go.
But that's what you get when Wu-Tang raised you. Y'all can't stop me. Go hard like I got an 808 in my heartbeat. And I'm eating at the beat like it gave a little speed to a great white shark on shark. We rock. Time to go off. Gone. Deuces goodbye. I got a world to see. And my girl, she wanna see Rome. Caesar make you a believer. Nah, I never ever did it for a throne. That validation comes from giving it back to the people. Now sing this song and it goes like, raise those hands. This is our party. We came here to live life like nobody was watching. I got my city right behind me. If I fall, they got me. Learn from that failure, gain humility, and then we keep marching.
Yeah, and we go back. This is the moment. Tonight is the night. We'll fight till it's over. So we put our hands up like the ceiling can't hold us. Like the ceiling can't hold us.
We go back.
This is the moment. Tonight is the night. We'll fight till it's over. So we put our hands up like the ceiling can't hold us. Like the ceiling can't hold us.
Green Bay, Wisconsin, also known as Titletown, USA. And welcome to the 70th annual Wisconsin FBLA State Leadership Conference. Together, we achieve. Our opening session will begin in 10 minutes. I'd like to ask everyone to please take your seats. Be sure to post your photos using the hashtag that's on the screen, hashtag WIFBLASLC. See you in 10 minutes.
Shakes and it bends, don't give a damn. When the night's here,
May I have everyone's attention, please? We are now 5 minutes away from the start of the 2024 Wisconsin FBLA State Leadership Conference. We're going to start the 5 minute countdown clock, so please take your seats. In a true Green Bay Packers fashion, let's get ready to kick off this year's opening session. Let's get started, everyone. Wisconsin FBLA members, welcome to the 2024 Wisconsin FBLA State Leadership Conference. We are here in beautiful Green Bay, a city known for excellence and strong leadership, exemplified by people like Vince Lombardi, for whom the Super Bowl trophy is named. The right leadership is crucial to the success of any team or organization. And so it is my pleasure to introduce your 2023-2024 Wisconsin FBLA State Officer Team. Ladies and gentlemen, Team 70. Representing Region 7 is your Vice President, Carlos Rivera Acevedo from Kenosha Bradford High School. Ladies and gentlemen, Carlos Rivera Acevedo. Your next Vice President is Region 6, Brody Waldron from Chilton High School. Ladies and gentlemen, Brody Waldron. And now, please welcome your Vice President of Region 5, Jamie Dam from Columbus High School. A round of applause for Jamie Dam. Representing Region 4 is your next Vice President, Brooklyn Mesra from River Ridge High School. Please welcome Brooklyn Mesra. Up next is your Region 3 Vice President, Haley Van Rens from Suring High School. Welcome, Haley Van Rens. Now coming to the stage is your Region 2 Vice President, Jennifer Espinoza from Athens High School. Ladies and gentlemen, Jennifer Espinoza. From Region 1, please welcome Gabrielle Peterson from Chippewa Falls High School. Ladies and gentlemen, Gabrielle Peterson. The FBLA parliamentarian has the important job of keeping us in line with our rules, policies, and procedures. And now please allow me to introduce your parliamentarian, Alexis Grovender from Shawamagon High School. Ladies and gentlemen, Alexis Grovender. The next office I'd like to introduce is your Wisconsin FBLA state reporter, Taylor Kolashinsky from Menasha High School. Please welcome Taylor Kolashinsky. Ladies and gentlemen, your Wisconsin FBLA secretary treasurer, Brock Titus from Hayward High School. A round of applause for Brock Titus. Your second in command, the Wisconsin FBLA vice president, please welcome Jaden Pouts from Gillett High School. Ladies and gentlemen, Jaden Pouts. And finally, your 2023-2024 Wisconsin FBLA president, Alabia Prasad from Muskego High School. Ladies and gentlemen, Alabia Prasad. Members and advisors, let's have one final round of applause for your Team 70, your Wisconsin FBLA State Leadership Team.
As your state president, I would like to officially call the opening session of the 2024 Wisconsin FBLA State Leadership Conference to order. Good morning to our Wisconsin FBLA members, both here and on the live stream. As we celebrate all we've achieved together this year, this conference presents a great opportunity for you to connect and network with your fellow FBLA members from around the state. Building relationships is key in any professional setting, and this event provides an ideal platform to do just that. A lot of lifelong friendships have started at this conference, so let's make the most of our time here, and we'll continue to achieve great things together. While you are here, we hope you will post to social media and share your conference experiences. Make sure to tag Wisconsin FBLA using the hashtag up on the screen. We look forward to seeing your posts and celebrating with you. Our theme this year is Together We Achieve, and your state FBLA leadership lives out to that promise by supporting you and helping you grow and succeed. All year long, we connect and inform our members. We provide competition tips and keep you informed of upcoming deadlines and events. We highlight your stories throughout Wisconsin by featuring a member of the month on our social media. Whether you are here representing your chapter for their leadership, membership accomplishments, or involvement with community service, you all have shown your dedication to FBLA. You've worked so hard to earn your spot at this conference. And for that, you should give yourselves a round of applause. We are excited to see who will represent Wisconsin at this year's National Leadership Conference in Orlando, June 29th through July 2nd. Competitors, good luck to each of you. During this first delegate session, we will also hear from a group of emerging leaders that are vying to move up to even more amazing leadership opportunities within FBLA. Soon, we will be introducing you to the Wisconsin FBLA 2024-2025 State Officer Candidates. Candidates, thank you for your commitment to serve in these roles, and we wish you the best of luck. We have a busy slate planned for these 2 days, and you won't want to miss any of it. Make sure you don't forget, download the conference app from the Apple Store or Google Play. Just search for Guidebook. After you download Guidebook, look for 2024 WIFBLA SLC. Wisconsin FBLA, together we can achieve anything. Let's make the most of every opportunity. And now, we will kick off this conference by honoring our flag.
As is our tradition, we will start our opening session by honoring our country and the men and women that protect our freedom. Please stand as we pay tribute to their service. Please welcome the American Legion Post 11 Sullivan Wallen Color Guard to present the flags, and Henry Paolo from Denmark High School FBLA to sing the national anthem. Please remain standing until the colors are retired.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Thank you, Henry. Everyone may now be seated. All of us are so glad to again be holding our state leadership conference in beautiful Green Bay. As everyone knows, this is the home of Lambeau Field, the greatest football stadium in America, and the Green Bay Packers, the greatest team in the history of professional football. But there is so much more to Green Bay than the Packers and Lambeau Field. Here to welcome us to his amazing city is the president of Discover Green Bay. Everyone, please welcome Brad Toll.
Good morning. I feel a little underdressed. You are looking great this morning. Pleasure to be able to be here with you this morning to say welcome to Green Bay. We are absolutely thrilled that you're here because you really are the future of business. And along with Lambeau Field and those things, we have a lot of businesses here in our community that are always looking for talented new people. So having you here exposed to the business in Green Bay is a wonderful opportunity to have you here to learn a little bit, perhaps, that we have great education when it comes to trades. NWTC, a great liberal arts college at St. Norbert College. UWGB, the fastest growing university in our system. So a huge opportunity. A lot of people in business always look at the economic impact that comes from different events that come in. It's our job to go out and find those and recruit them to Green Bay, like the FBLA conference. Your conference is about 800 room nights per night, about 1,600 total. And that's going to have an economic impact of over $1 million in Green Bay. Thank you for being here. So one other little event that's coming to Green Bay very soon, next year, a little bit bigger than FBLA, but certainly no more valuable, is the NFL Draft. We are very excited about that one. It's taken us 8 years to recruit that to Green Bay. Working with our partners over at the Packers, that one's going to have a $20 million impact just on the Green Bay area, $94 million if we look at the entire state of Wisconsin. That is awesome. Part of the advantage of that too, you know, you look at the initial economic impact, but as people see that that's being hosted here in Green Bay, they're thinking, wow, my convention could go to Green Bay. My special event could go to Green Bay. So it's other business that we may be able to track. Who's in marketing? You know, there's a lot of different areas of business. Marketing has changed so much, and it's fascinating how we're using new tools for the draft. Used to be you put together a nice ad, people saw it in a magazine, you hoped they did something, but you really didn't know. We're geofencing Detroit this year, and if you have your location services on your phone or you use your credit card, we've got you. And we'll be sending messages to those people about being in Green Bay next year. We can feed them things through the course of the year. Now, not individually, of course, knowing who everyone is, but that aggregate tells us a lot about the event. For example, in Kansas City, Cleveland, Nashville too, to a certain extent, we know 60 to 65% of the people drove. So if that's the case, unless you're swimming to Green Bay, you're driving through the state of Wisconsin, whether you're coming from the south, the west, or the north. And that's how we know the impact is going to be great throughout the state of Wisconsin in that 94 million area. But our marketing people are busy, and they'll be very busy in Detroit. making certain that we're able to take advantage of all the people that were there and invite them to Green Bay as well. Congratulations on getting to where you're at here in Green Bay, and very much luck to you this week. Our business community is excited about being judges. We're very nice here, so don't worry about that. And good luck to you. We hope you all get to go to Orlando. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you, Mr. Toll. The Wisconsin FBLA Foundation shows its support of our organization by bringing businesses and education together to create opportunities for Wisconsin FBLA members. Their involvement is critical in allowing each of us to succeed in leadership, personal growth, volunteer opportunities, and educational experiences. Here to represent the foundation and explain how they can help you reach your goals, please welcome to the stage Foundation Board President Dave Thomas.
On behalf of the Wisconsin FBLA Foundation, I welcome and congratulate all our members who are competing as part of the State Leadership Conference. The Foundation is a nonprofit, volunteer-based organization that receives financial support from both current members and alumni. This past December, I had the honor of being elected as the Foundation President to serve alongside Directors Allison Schneider and Stephanie Jansen. And we are very pleased to provide over $27,000 in support to local opportunities this year that are promoted through your state officer team. Our efforts this year have expanded the champion chapter financial awards by implementing a tiered structure of support for local chapters who achieve gold, silver, or bronze status. Additionally, we're expanding support to the middle level chapters who are the recipient of the chapter merit awards at either the excellence or achievement levels. To support the continued growth in FBLA opportunities across the state, we are also continuing to provide financial support to our new and reactivated chapters. At the membership level, the foundation will also be recognizing recipients of the Business Achievement Awards through a random gift card drawing for all completers who receive one entry for each level that is completed. The foundation has operated for over 25 years with the purpose to support leadership development activities as well as assist members with expenses and attend conference activities. The Board of Directors hope that the Foundation's annual support to local chapters has allowed you, our members, the opportunity to achieve an inspirational experience that has helped to prepare you to become community-minded business leaders in our global society through relevant career preparation and leadership experiences. Together, we achieve a bright future in Wisconsin with you as our future business leaders. Thank you.
Thank you, Dave, for sharing all that the foundation does to support Wisconsin FBLA members and chapters. The life-changing opportunities we receive through FBLA are supported by business leaders throughout our community and nation, individuals that truly believe together we achieve. With their financial support and business expertise, they are one of the main reasons FBLA is a thriving organization. It is now time to present the 2024 Business Person of the Year Award. It is our pleasure to present this award to Candy Webster. Candy, please make your way to the stage. Candy is the president of Webster's Marketplace in Ripon, and she has given back to Ripon FBLA in the Ripon community for over 10 years. Candy has supported FBLA in her community by presenting speeches, sponsoring and supporting FBLA activities, giving her time and talents, and assisting with financial support of FBLA members to compete at the regional, state, and national conferences. The Webster's Foundation has also fully funded Ripon FBLA's Money Smart Book Read event for the last 7 years, which provides a book for every kindergarten through second grade student in Ripon to take home. Beyond her FBLA support, she has also won several awards for her work, including the 2021 Supermarket Hero Award presented by the Wisconsin Grocers Association. Thank you, Candy, for all your support and all that you do to support FBLA and your community.
It should be pretty clear to all of us what an incredible job the Wisconsin FBLA staff and conference volunteers do in driving FBLA throughout the year and planning the State Leadership Conference. We would like to thank these individuals for their dedication to Wisconsin FBLA. Please stand when your name is called. Jen Jackson, Wisconsin FBLA State Advisor. Tracy Danowski, Headquarters Operations Specialist. Becky Dixon, Housing and Leadership Academy Co-Director. Laura Finke, Middle School State Conference Coordinator. Katie Grassel, Community and Transportation Director. Jan Imhoff, Competitive Event Director. Stephanie Jansen, Communication Outreach Specialist. Annette O'Hearn, Housing and Leadership Academy Co-Director. Tabitha Auden, Office Operations Assistant. And Elsa Nicola, Office Operations Assistant. Thank you all for what you do to help us achieve our goals for Wisconsin FBLA. Together, we can achieve anything when incredible leaders motivate their members and encourage them to get involved and be prepared. Chapter presidents, we would like you to grab your phone and get your flashlight ready because we want to spotlight you. FBLA is a successful organization because of the strong leaders that set the pace for their individual chapters throughout the state. These leaders keep their chapters organized and informed, but most importantly, create an environment where members can be successful. They conduct chapter business in proper parliamentary procedure and encourage each member to take advantage of all the opportunities FBLA has to offer. We would like to recognize these leaders within each local chapter. Will the chapter presidents in the room please stand and turn on your phone flashlights so we can see where you are? Wave it high. Thank you, chapter presidents. All right, FBLA members, now let's make some noise for our chapter advisors. Who thinks they have Wisconsin FBLA's best advisor? Our chapter advisors are the best at finding opportunities to help us be successful and reach our goals. They are our biggest fans, giving us motivation, support, and encouragement. Would all of our chapter advisors please stand? Thank you, advisors.
Where would we be without the support and encouragement of our chapter advisors? My advisor, Ms. Marlena LeMay, is the reason I am here at the podium, ready to compete. Together with our advisors, we are able to achieve. Every year, we honor one special advisor who has truly lived out the Together We Achieve motto and present them with the Outstanding Local Chapter Advisor of the Year Award. This year, we congratulate Laura Finke, computer science teacher at Oconomowoc High School, as our 2024 Outstanding Local Chapter Advisor for Wisconsin FBLA. Mrs. Finke, please join us on stage. Mrs. Finke has gone above and beyond to help students determine their passions. Are the words shared by a student member of the Oconomowoc FBLA chapter when they nominated Mrs. Finke for this award. She prepares students for regional, state, and national competitions so that the Oconomowoc students are as prepared and ready for the competitive events as possible. Fellow Region 7 advisor Sarah Burling of Menominee Falls shared how Mrs. Finke recruits members, provides leadership and professional opportunities, and prepares students for outstanding competition. Laura Finke truly exemplifies all the qualities of an outstanding advisor. She has also taken on the leadership role at the state level as Middle School State Leadership Conference Coordinator, and our middle school members have experienced the quality of events she works to organize and execute. Mrs. Finke has definitely earned this title, and she should be recognized by the state of Wisconsin. Please help us congratulate Mrs. Laura Finke of Oconomowoc High School on receiving this well-deserved honor as our 2024 Outstanding Local Chapter Advisor. She will also be recognized this summer at the National Leadership Conference in Orlando. Congratulations, Mrs. Finke.
Wisconsin FBLA grew at an amazing rate this past year as we added a total of 17 new and reactivated chapters. Let's start by first recognizing our 11 reactivated chapters. Please stand and show your pride when your school name is called. Highland High School. Westby High School. Wazika Steuben High School. Columbus Catholic High School. Dodgeville High School. Brookfield East High School. Sheboygan Christian High School. East Troy High School. Oregon High School. Spencer High School. And La Crosse Logan Middle School. And now, a big congratulations and welcome to our new chapters. Please stand when your name is called. Williams Bay High School. Wittenberg Burnhamwood High School. Edgewood High School. Altoona High School. Owen Withey Middle School. And Silverbrook Intermediate School. Congratulations to each of you for all you have accomplished this year in Wisconsin FBLA.
Before we hear from this year's state officer candidates, we'd like to remind you that the Office of Parliamentarian, the candidate with the highest score on the parliamentary procedure exam, will be appointed to the position. We have one candidate. The candidate for parliamentarian is Nicholas Soka of Germantown. Let's have a round of applause for Nicholas.
To achieve all our organization is capable of, we need strong leadership. We will be welcoming to the stage those leaders who have chosen to run for office on the Wisconsin FBLA state officer team. As Alabia mentioned earlier, we will be hearing from all the candidates throughout today's opening session. But before we begin here, there are some rules. The candidates and campaign managers may speak from this podium or use a handheld microphone. Each candidate will have 3 minutes to give his or her speech, except for the candidates for president, who will have 5 minutes. Parliamentarian Alexis Gravunder will be seated in the front row and will stand when 30 seconds are remaining. When your time is up, she will stand and call time. At that point, you must stop your speech. When the president raps her gavel, you must stop. The campaign speeches will be given in order of reporter, secretary treasurer, vice president, and president in alphabetical order by their last name per our bylaws. However, before we start the state level speeches, we will be hearing from Pragna Vella from Sun Prairie West High School. Pragna is seeking for your support as she runs for National North Central Region Vice President position.
Good morning, Wisconsin FBLA. My name is Pragna Vella, and I am thrilled to be here today asking for your vote to be Wisconsin's nominee for North Central Region Vice President. Throughout my FBLA journey, I have been deeply involved in our organization at the local, state, and national level. Last year, I was the Wisconsin nominee for the National Treasurer position. Today, I ask you to let me represent Wisconsin again by voting PV for VP. I would excel in this position not only because of my FBLA experience, but because I am a road trip expert. I've lived in California, Ohio, Colorado, New York, New Jersey, and finally, Wisconsin. Every destination gave me a new compass in leadership. It shaped me into a uniquely adaptable and persistent leader who can steer FBLA to success on the national level, as I will be working with chapters not only in Wisconsin, but across the country. So, let's chart our course by looking at two key roles of the North Central Region Vice President. The first role is to manage the North Central Region Council. As a member of the Wisconsin State FBLA Executive Councils, as well as leading teams of students outside FBLA as a national 4-H representative, I have the skills to effectively guide these councils to success. If elected, another one of my responsibilities would be to develop FBLA in our region. I will do this by promoting nationwide impactful community service projects. As the founder of a social justice volunteering club, CEO of my own nonprofit, and the recipient of 2 Gold Presidential Volunteer Service Awards with over 400 hours of community work, I am committed to giving back to the community and aim to help develop new initiatives that allows FBLA to do the same. From the moment I attended my very first RLC, I knew I had found my new home. To me, FBLA is not just about dressing up in suits and practicing our presentations to walls, it's about forging lifelong memories. So today, let's take a moment to celebrate how far we have all come in our FBLA journeys. Give yourselves a round of applause. As we near the end of our road trip together, let's not just look at our rearview mirrors, but focus on the path ahead. As your North Central Region Vice President, I will work relentlessly to be a leader, friend, and co-pilot in each of your journeys to success. All you have to do is vote for it. Wisconsin FBLA, I ask you to make me your nominee for North Central Region Vice President. Vote PV for VP. Thank you.
We will now hear from our officer candidates. We will start with the officer candidates running for the position of reporter. All speeches will be given alphabetically by last name within each office. The duties of state reporter are to record and report any newsworthy events of the state chapter. There is one candidate for the office of state reporter. Please welcome Adelyn Bogenschneider from Wisconsin Lutheran High School.
Good luck. Hello, Wisconsin FBLA. Thank you to everyone for being here today at the 2024 SLC. My name is Adeline Bogenschneider, and I'm very excited to be running for your Wisconsin State Reporter. I'm currently a junior at Wisconsin Lutheran High School and in my second year of FBLA. Now let's rewind to 2022 at the end of my freshman year of high school. It was the last assembly of the year, and senior students gathered on stage to announce new programs for the next year. At the end of the presentation, they mentioned creating a new Future Business Leaders of America chapter. I did not know then that that one announcement would change the outcome of my entire high school career. Fast forward to now, and I'm the president of my chapter. Starting and running a chapter hasn't been easy. With my advisors, executive board, and members working together, we've been able to create a very successful chapter together. FBLA has encouraged my chapter and I to truly work hard and understand that the outcome is worth all the hard work. As the president of my chapter, I have grown membership, spread awareness about FBLA, helped run successful fundraisers, and worked to get members to qualify at the state and national levels. Through FBLA, I have met a wide network of business professionals, passionate leaders, and friends. Being in FBLA has allowed me to grow my own personal business and leadership skills, and I see the impact that it has had on all of you here today. FBLA isn't just another high school club or organization, but a community full of bright entrepreneurs ready to learn and grow together. I want to help our FBLA region grow its membership, connections, offerings, and goals. As state reporter, I want to help grow membership through the state of Wisconsin. I can accomplish this using social media, email, promotion, and other forms of communication. I've noticed that the most successful organizations utilize mass communication and media to grow the organization, so continuing to use that within FBLA is super important. Another goal of mine would be to improve the communication among new chapters and established chapters and regions. I noticed that my high school, when we were starting our chapter, it was very difficult to find all of the information and even know what FBLA actually is. Improving communication, helping new chapters one-on-one, will offer a personalized connection that will improve the relationship between chapters and regional and state leadership. Another goal of mine would be to diversify our organization. I want everyone at FBLA to feel represented and welcomed. Everyone having a voice and a say is so important. Having a balance within FBLA and offering the same opportunities to every chapter and region is vital. When everyone has access to their best and have input, we can then grow as an organization. Lastly, I want to thank you all for allowing me to be here today. I'm grateful for your support, and I understand that FBLA is a great privilege that we're all blessed to have. I am ecstatic to meet throughout the day at workshops, events, and at my booth. I wish you all the best and to have a lot of fun. As you enter to vote today, please consider voting for me, Adeline Bogenschneider, to serve you as your Wisconsin State Reporter. Thank you.
For the first time in Wisconsin FBLA history, your state officers have implemented state executive councils. Each council is based on the respective officers' program of work initiatives. Through these councils, Wisconsin FBLA members have had the opportunity to implement new resources and programs for our members to utilize while growing their leadership skills and understanding the work of a state officer. We would like to recognize each of our council members serving on each executive council for the 2023-2024 membership year. State President, Communications Director, Anna Jarvis from Gilmanton High School. State President, National and State Programs Director, Matthew Ginnan from Mineral Point High School. State Vice President, Communications Director, Lenora Januzzi from Middleton High School. State Vice President, March of Dimes Director, Sophie Dale from Oak Creek High School. State Secretary Treasurer, Communications Director, Gavin Rabarchek from Muskego High School. State Secretary, Treasurer, Financial Literacy Director Max Olson from Middleton High School. State Reporter, Communications Director Annalisa Packney from West Bend High School. State Reporter, Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion Director Tatum Morrison from Wisconsin Rapids Area Middle School. State Parliamentarian, Communication Director Kaylee Peterson from Muskego High School. State Parliamentarian Outreach Director, Pragna Vella from Sun Prairie West High School. The duties of the State Secretary Treasurer are to keep accurate records at every meeting and to present detailed minutes. This role also tracks all income and expenses of the organization and prepares reports to the membership on the financial status of the organization. There were no candidates for the office of State Secretary Treasurer. In accordance with the Wisconsin FBLA Constitution and Bylaws, Section 6, Subsection F, Subsection 2, in the case of no qualified candidates for the office, the officer will be chosen in order of election and highest votes. The second highest scoring presidential candidate qualifying for the office of Secretary Treasurer will become the State Secretary Treasurer.
It's now time to hear from the candidates running for State Vice President. The responsibility of the State Vice President is to assist the President and be ready to preside and lead the state in the absence of the President. There are four candidates for the position of State Vice President. The first candidate we will hear from is Owen Akins from Menasha High School.
Good morning, Wisconsin FBLA. My name is Owen Akins, and I am honored to be a candidate for Vice President. Jackie Robinson once said, "Life is not a spectator sport. If you're gonna spend your whole life in the grandstand just watching what goes on around you, you might as well, in my opinion, you're wasting your life." I'm running for Vice President because being a spectator has never been something rooted in me. I'm a junior at Menasha High School, playing in football and baseball. In addition, I am the Vice President at my local chapter at Menasha and the chair of the fundraising committee. I also work in the swag shop where we sell Menasha apparel and an active member of my parish. Growing up in a four-generation family business has been both a privilege and an invaluable learning experience. As a member of a small family business that has probably thrived for over a century, I've had the opportunity to immerse myself in leadership and the dynamics of entrepreneurship and customer service. Ensuring guests have a positive experience, leading team on job site installs, and along with taking direction and insight from the president of the company has helped me grow and understand what it takes to sustain tradition. When I first stepped up to play in FBLA, my business instincts kicked in like a powerful swing. I was thrilled to move from the stands to the field and ready to contribute and make a positive change. With this game-changing mindset, I've set three goals for this term. One, I'd like to boost FBLA membership at the middle school and high school levels. By highlighting the skills and leadership opportunities FBLA provides, we can attract more members at both levels. Encouraging current members to share their experiences and hosting interactive workshops can ignite interest and inspire others to join. Additionally, setting up a college-level FBLA in Wisconsin is a visionary goal of mine. Working with the state FBLA office and colleges to show how FBLA can enhance the college experience is crucial. This initiative can create a seamless transition for students to continue their FBLA journey in Wisconsin beyond high school. Two, I would like to assist FBLA members across Wisconsin to enhance their community service efforts by providing a framework for successful projects that can be adapted by chapters. We can promote mentorship program where we experience chapters guide newer ones and organizing events. Three, I'd like to expand networking and partnerships opportunities. I'd start by reaching out to businesses and connect with FBLA alumni who would be interested in working with us. I would initiate conversations with them about how we can support each other and use a social media to showcase our projects and the outcomes. As your Wisconsin VP, I promise not to strike out as your leader. I'm not just a spectator bringing in academic knowledge, but a team player with hands-on understanding of what it means to be a part of a successful, long-standing business. With these goals in my lineup, I'm ready to step onto the FBLA diamond, swing for the fences, and hit a home run for a state. I look forward to the opportunity to be on this journey as your state VP candidate. So here's the pitch. Throw your vote my way, and let's get down FBLA business together. Thank you.
Next, we welcome Aaron Lisinski from Muskego High School.
Some days, I wish I could be a dinosaur. Now I know that may seem a bit strange, but my love for dinosaurs is real. Hello, I'm Erin Lashinsky, and I'm running to be your next Wisconsin FBLA State Vice President. Join me on this roaring journey as I explain just how dinosaur characteristics will help lead me to be your next Vice President. How many of you have watched Jurassic Park or Jurassic World? John Hammond's vision for Jurassic Park was grand, but vision alone isn't enough. Leaders must take action. First, I'm committed to increasing the impact of our community service initiatives. I propose to enhance recognition and celebration of our amazing members and chapters who go above and beyond. Let's recognize the great community service we do to give back to others. Now, take a moment to look at the members to your left. Now look at the members to your right. What do you notice? Unless you have an identical twin sitting directly next to you, you may have noticed that we're all different. Same goes for dinosaurs. They all came in various shapes and sizes. Just how diverse teams can be powerful, bring different skills, perspectives, and backgrounds. Therefore, my next goal is to foster a stronger sense of connection. As your future state vice president, I will strengthen our organization by implementing a network platform where ideas, resources, experiences, and questions can be shared. The strength of our organization can enhance our overall experience. Finally, how about we take a moment to recognize our current state officer team? We need to recognize that Wisconsin FBLA has been led by amazing officers for many years. Same goes for dinosaurs who are prehistoric rock stars that ruled the earth for many years. Our FBLA officers have paved the way, and I believe it's important for us to continue the initiatives and opportunities that are set in place for us. For example, did you know our current officer team started FBLA councils, which help guide and support the initiatives of Wisconsin FBLA? In addition, our officers have worked hard to secure business sponsors for our national qualifiers to reduce costs. Former officers have done so many great things, and it's our job to continue to do all the things we're already doing so well. Together, we can take FBLA to new heights. First, let's connect our members and advisors across the state. Second, amplify our impact through community service. And third, continue to support the initiatives that have made our organization amazing. Thank you for your time and consideration. I, Aaron Lashinsky, am running to be your next Wisconsin FBLA State Vice President. Do you want to be a dinosaur? Let's hear you roar!
Now, please welcome Elton Ross from Wapaka High School.
Good morning. My name is Elton Ross, and I'm a sophomore and the secretary for Wapaka's FBLA chapter. Though fairly new to FBLA, this is my second year, I have tried to get as involved as possible in my local chapter. So when I learned that there were state officer positions that could be ran for, I knew it was a new way to get involved. But that's enough about me. I'm not running for me. I'm running to be your vice president. The most important part of FBLA is the members, and that is why, if elected, I will work to make the FBLA community better for all of us. I will work to make communication between the executive board and members better to keep us all informed. I will also help to create service projects to get the FBLA name out so people in our great state hopefully become members. But really, I'm running to make your FBLA experience better. Be a boss, vote for Ross. So.
Our final vice president candidate is Pragna Vella from Sun Prairie West High School.
Good morning, Wisconsin FBLA. My name is Pragna Vella, and I am honored to be running to serve you as your next state vice president. Today, I encourage you to vote PV for VP. In the words of esteemed doctor and philanthropist, Taylor Swift, life isn't just about how to survive the storm, it's about how to dance in the rain. As your state vice president, I aim to help you all be fearless in the face of challenges, shake off obstacles, and fill in the blank space with inspiring accomplishments. I have been a part of FBLA since the very first year it started in my high school. Now, I serve as my local chapter's president and have increased chapter membership by over 770%. I have won first place at regionals and state, placed fifth at NLC, as well as top 10 internationally in the FBLA Equity Challenge. But let's not talk about my qualifications for this position. What really matters is what I can do for you. I have developed a three-stage plan for Wisconsin FBLA called Progna's Pathways to Success. Currently, I serve as a member of the Wisconsin State FBLA Executive Councils. If elected, my first pathway will be to work with these councils to develop new initiatives that improve our organization. My second pathway is developing community service projects. One of the key responsibilities of the state vice president is to coordinate statewide community service initiatives, including March of Dimes fundraisers. This past year, I led a team of FBLA members in my local chapter to organize a 5K fundraiser for the March of Dimes that raised approximately $2,000. Additionally, I created volunteering partnerships with local businesses, which allowed my chapter to accumulate over 455 volunteer hours in the past year. I will continue to promote organizing impactful volunteer projects like these as your state vice president. My third and final pathway is middle school mentorship. This year, I founded my school district's first middle school FBLA chapter and will be guiding these middle schoolers in their FBLA journeys. Similarly, as state vice president, I will create and adopt a chapter program that pairs middle and high school chapters. Wisconsin FBLA, I would be enchanted to serve you as your Team 71 state vice president. I pledge to empower you all to dance through the rain and turn your wildest dreams into your achievements. So, when it comes time to cast your vote, remember, vote PV for VP. Thank you.
We want to acknowledge the previously elected regional vice presidents at this time. Please stand when your name is called. And everyone else, please cheer on your region and we'll see who's the loudest. Representing Region 1, Annabelle Worley from St. Croix Central High School. Your Region 2 Vice President, Emma Reilly from Edgar High School. Region 3 Vice President is Morgan Evans from Shawano High School. Region 4 is represented by Trinity Clays from Fenimore High School. Your Region 5 Vice President is Rashika Komuri from Middleton High School. From Region 6, Mason Klon from Sheboygan Falls High School. And finally, Region 7, let's hear it for your Vice President, Layla Serrano from Oak Creek High School. Congratulations to each of you.
The March of Dimes and FBLA have a long history as successful partners in fundraising, volunteering, and service. There are multiple ways that you, through your local chapter, can join FBLA's commitment to improving the lives of babies. I encourage you to be a part of a local March of Dimes fundraising walk or create your own local fundraising initiative to show your support. We are in our second year of having a traveling trophy for the region that gives the most in support for the March of Dimes. Each region raised money during their miracle moment to support the work of March of Dimes, but we are trying something new here at SLC. In the information desk area, there are 7 jars for members and advisors to add their March of Dimes donations. All money collected here in Green Bay will be added to what was raised at the regional conference to determine the winner of the traveling trophy. Money will be collected today until the end of second general session tonight. The winning region will be announced tomorrow during the Awards of Excellence.
Duties of state president are to lead the state chapter in all activities and preside over all meetings. There are 3 candidates for the office of state president. First, please welcome Kalea Biddick from Mineral Point High School.
Good morning, Wisconsin FBLA. My name is Kalea Biddick, and I'm from Mineral Point High School. I am thrilled to be standing here before you today, running for the position of FBLA State President. First and foremost, I'd like to express my gratitude towards FBLA for providing me the opportunity to run for this position. I understand the significance of this responsibility, and I assure you that I am fully committed to upholding the values and principles that define FBLA. FBLA has been a hugely significant part of my life since the beginning of my freshman year. It has provided me with transformative conferences, exciting competitions, and remarkable networking opportunities. I have chosen to pursue the position of state president because I have a strong passion for service, and I feel that I have the potential to serve our district in an innovative and productive manner. My qualifications for this role stem from my experience with FBLA, my education within the business field, and my dedication to principles of leadership and service. I have a background in being my chapter's local publicity manager, my school drama club's business manager, and a track record of over 100 community service hours. I have also earned 12 college credits within the field of business. I am skilled in areas of strategic thinking, problem solving, and understanding the needs and aspirations of our members. This involvement has equipped me with the knowledge to drive positive change, engage in collaborative efforts, and propel FBLA to new heights of success. In terms of my vision for FBLA's future, I am a firm believer in the power of service through collaboration. As state president, my first goal would be to promote this among members, whether it be through networking, workshops, or specific service projects. By utilizing each other's strengths and expertise, we can amplify our impact and create meaningful change within our communities while enriching the ethicality of FBLA's brand. After all, it is together that we achieve. Furthermore, I am deeply passionate about empowering the next generation of business leaders. I believe it is our responsibility to provide mentorship and guidance to aspiring entrepreneurs and professionals to equip them with the tools and knowledge they need to succeed in the ever-evolving business world. This leads me to my second goal, which would be to increase the amount of business achievement awards earned. I would achieve this goal by expanding advertising for the award to make members further inclined to complete the program. Expanding the outreach of the BAA would emphasize the educational pillar of FBLA and allow more members to build knowledge that is critical to the essence of FBLA. Lastly, I am committed to ensuring transparency and accountability in FBLA's operations. As state president, my third goal would be to promote inclusivity and maintain open lines of communication with members. This would foster a communication-oriented culture to build trust and cohesion within our organization. I am deeply honored to have had the opportunity to run for FBLA state president. If elected, I would work tirelessly to promote service through collaboration, increase education through the Business Achievement Awards, and encourage inclusivity by enhancing communication between the board and members. With your support, I am confident that we can achieve greatness and make a meaningful difference in the world of business and beyond. Thank you, and I wish you all good luck in your competitive events.
Thank you, Kalea. Our second candidate running for president is Jamie Dam from Columbus High School.
Hello, Wisconsin FBLA. I'm Jamie Dam, and I want to be your Wisconsin FBLA state president. I'm currently a junior at Columbus High School in Region 5, and I am so excited to be running for this position. To me, the most important part of running for such a crucial position within an organization is the ability to follow through with initiatives, not only my own, but also those of the rest of the officer team, as well as the past one. Based on my knowledge and skill of what it takes to follow through with initiatives, as well as seeing the inner aspect of leading a team, I believe that I would be a great choice for president. Remember, it's not a scam to vote for Dam. This past year, I had the opportunity to serve as your Region 5 vice president. I learned many crucial skills, including networking, communication, and planning. I was also able to see firsthand the tasks and work that it takes to be state president. During my past term, I was able to travel to NLC in Atlanta and represent Wisconsin FBLA, while meeting new people and hearing their stories. I was able to meet countless inspiring youth from middle and high school level. I had the opportunity to share my FBLA journey, not only with all the state officers, but also with community members, both in person and on our local radio network. And finally, my biggest accomplishment during my term was planning and hosting the Region 5 Leadership Conference at my own school with 600 attendees. Having planned Region 5's regionals this year, I believe that I would be able to guide the newly elected regional vice presidents with the planning of their own regionals. Outside of FBLA, I'm an active member in the 4-H community. I'm currently serving a 2-year term on the Wisconsin 4-H Leadership Council, and I have led workshops and sessions numerous times. Having a very strong presence within the organization has helped me develop my communication, leadership, and problem-solving skills. Through conferences and summer camps, I was able to develop these. I also participate in 3 sports and 9 other organizations and clubs, including the CHS Drama Department, FFA, NHS, and many more. I serve as an officer-elect and team captain in many of these extracurriculars. Because of these opportunities, I've developed many of the skills that I feel are necessary to lead as your next state president. Through the various conferences I have attended, I learned of many members' stories, including those of the financially less fortunate. It was then that I truly realized many members couldn't compete or couldn't have their family, peers, and guardians there to support them. One of the hardest things to hear is how someone was scammed out of an opportunity based on something out of their control. I know that financials are a major aspect of taking opportunities, and one of the 3 pillars within FBLA is progress. And in order for us, as an organization, to make progress, I think it's important that we address the financial struggles within the community. In this role, I would like to start a scholarship program within FBLA. The scholarship fund would be available to members as soon as we can get it running. It would provide funds to individuals or chapters on an application basis. This application would be made for members and advisors to share how much they would need, what they would use the funds for, and how it would directly benefit them. If I'm elected, I have many goals, but my main initiative while in office would be to build a scholarship program, because I strongly believe that members and advisors should not be limited by the financial contributions of their families and chapters. Besides building a scholarship program, I also want to strengthen the bond between FBLA and the 5 other CTSO organizations, build new statewide opportunities within FBLA for members to network and explore the inner workings as well as the extent of the business world, and finally, to grow FBLA's membership. With the help of the upcoming officer team, as well as our expansive membership, I believe that all of these would be very plausible. I'm Jamie Dam, and I want to be your next state president.
Remember, it's not a scam to vote for Dam. Thank you.
Thank you, Jamie. Our final candidate for president is Vincent Nemath of Burlington High School.
Good morning, Wisconsin FBLA. My name is Vincent Nemath, and I'm here to share my visions for our chapter's future and why I'm the best candidate for state president. Before I dive into my goals, it is important for you to get to know me first. I come from Region 7, or more specifically, Burlington High School. I'm currently a junior, and this is my third year in FBLA. I've been an officer for my chapter for 2 years, and I'm currently the reporter. I also partake in forensics, choir, cross country, cheerleading, and prom committee. I've also partaken in our city's park board, and I have also partaken in our theatrical productions at Burlington High School. I'm quite a busy bee, but even then, I've always put FBLA first, and I intend to continue this trend as I move on to a state office. And before I begin, a quick shout out to the amazing women on my campaign committee. Without them, none of this would have been possible. Now, let's discuss the future. I propose a vision built on three crucial pillars. Firstly, growth. It's time to expand FBLA's outreach across Wisconsin by establishing new chapters at both the middle and high school levels. I plan to advocate for this within our state's districts and highlight the benefits of FBLA membership. This expansion is crucial for securing our chapter's foundation. Secondly, diversity. Our FBLA family should reflect the diverse perspectives of the United States. I pledge to promote inclusivity, drawing from my own experiences of overcoming homelessness. By celebrating our differences and providing opportunities to all students, regardless of background, we can create an environment where everyone feels valued and supported. Finally, public awareness. Let's amplify FBLA's impact beyond our school walls through strategic partnerships and outreach initiatives. By showcasing the opportunities FBLA provides, we can inspire more students to join our ranks and embark on their journey to success. So, what's the plan of action? It begins with collaboration, working hand in hand with educators, administrators, and local communities to establish strong roots for FBLA. We'll create mentorship programs, ensuring that experienced FBLA members guide and inspire the middle schoolers and freshmen who are stepping into our shoes. Moreover, I propose incentivizing outreach in all regions that will be more focused on finding interested new members. It is impossible to grow as a community without physically having that community to begin with. A key component is the establishment of these middle school chapters, which will create experienced high school members who aren't afraid to participate. So, my fellow FBLAers, as the base of my cheer team, it is my role to physically support my teammates so they can fly high and for the stars. As state president, I promise to be that base that holds you up as you reach for those stars. And of course, to cheer you on. Wisconsin FBLA, let's embark on this journey together, one that expands our reach, embraces diversity, and captures attention. Wisconsin FBLA, the time for transformative leadership is now, and I'm ready to lead us toward that future. With me as your president, FBLA becomes synonymous with success. Thank you, and I hope you all have an amazing time at State. I'll be cheering on each and every one of you. Vin Vin for the win-win.
Thank you, Vincent. Good luck to all of our candidates. Members, don't forget to attend the campaign booths where your voting delegates have an opportunity to ask questions for the candidates to help you in casting your vote for Team 71. The campaign booths will be open today in the rotunda from 10:30 to 12:30. All candidates for elected positions will be at their campaign booths, ready to speak with you before voting delegates cast their ballot between 1:30 to 3:30 in Ballroom A1.
Before we close out the opening session, we have just a few announcements. You want to check your conference app for all the upcoming workshops. There you will find the titles, times, and locations for each workshop. Downloading the app is easy.
Just open the App Store on your phone to download the Guidebook app. Then search for 2024 Wisconsin FBLA SLC. If you don't have a smartphone, you can create an account on the website and set your own conference schedule using the website. When blocking out your next few days, we encourage you to participate in the 15th annual College and Career Fair, where you can gain insight on many post-high school opportunities. This year's fair will be the largest to date, with representatives from across the Badger State, plus other Midwest schools and vendors who help to support this amazing conference. The fair takes place tomorrow, starting at 10 a.m. until 1:30 p.m. across the convention center.
Don't forget to sign up for the bus tours. You'll have the opportunity to visit area colleges and Green Bay area businesses. Tickets are available for $15. If you are interested, your advisor must sign you up and pay for you at the information desk. But seats are limited and are on a first-come, first-served basis. Following the second general session tonight, we will have our first block party right here in the KI. Students will be able to change into casual attire and then take part in trivia contests, show off their karaoke skills, capture memories in our photo booth, watch the NCAA National Championship game, or take place in some friendly, competitive games and yard games. We hope you all join us for this fun time with your fellow FBLA members from across the state. Here are a few more last-minute details. Final performance schedules will be updated as results are made available. You can find these schedules on the Wisconsin FBLA website, Wisconsin FBLA Facebook page, and by checking the app. Reminder, there are 5 role play events that will be having their finals today. So be sure to hit refresh to see if you've made it one step closer to Orlando and NLC.
Before we close this opening session, I would like to encourage you to maintain the high FBLA standard here at the KI Convention Center and at your hotels. All participants are asked to observe quiet hours at the hotel beginning at 10 p.m. Remember that curfew is at midnight. Make sure to wear your conference badge at all times, even during bus tours and breakout sessions. Replacements may be acquired at the information desk. If your advisor is not present, then members must provide a photo ID. For safety purposes, do not wear your badge when you are outside the conference center. In preparation for nationals, all competitors are required to bring a photo ID to your event. This can be a driver's license, identification card, or school ID. You will need to have it along with your conference badge in order to be admitted for your competition. Buses parked in the Associated Bank parking lot must be moved as soon as possible to the yellow meters on Elm Street. Advisors, please inform bus drivers. Habusin 1553 Progressive Bus in Shawamigan. Good luck to each of our competitors and officer candidates. We will see you back here tonight at 8 p.m. for the executive board meeting and second general session. Please remember that business attire is required and doors will open at 7:30 p.m. Our opening session is adjourned.